Hello everybody, this is Harrison, and you may be wondering, no, you're not. If you've seen our videos, you probably know what this is. This is part of our room. It's like right when you walk in, you see this. But by the way, that thing there, oh, no. See that thing in the background? That's Greg. I just drew Greg's face. Bernard, I think. Today, I'm Harrison from Rome Kids, if you don't know, but, and if you just barely got on to this channel, well, just welcome to this channel, but, this, kind of weird, it's a little weird setup, but today, look at the title of this, and I'm going to be, so, the title of this video is like me reading Diary of a Wimpy Kid, but Bad Kitty, Happy Birthday, Bad Kitty. So I don't really know what book this is. I know I've read some of the Bad Kitty books. I just love the Bad Kitty books. I've only read two, but I really love them. So I mean, I'm going to be reading this one. I've never read it before. I really want to read this. It looks super good, but today I'm going to be reading for 20 minutes because, you know, 20 minutes is going to be good. So, I'm going to start reading. 3, 2, 1. Chapter 1. Good morning, Kitty. By the way, you can see this, like, backwards because it's in the video. That's just an illustration. I'm not going to show you the illustrations because they're just a waste of time. Today is going to be a great day. The sun is shining. The birds are singing. Flowers are blooming everywhere with all the colors of the rainbow. Zzz. So, Bad Kitty is sleeping right now. Do you know what today is? Don't you? I mean, oh, you know what today is, don't you, Kitty? Today is a very special day. Today is the kind of day that only comes once a year. Today is the kind of day that you celebrate all day long. Today is the kind of day that deserves a big, fun party. Now, do you know what today is? I keep saying just, then, like, snort so that kid is still sleeping. Today is your birthday, it says on that page. It says just that on that page. And then Bad Kids is like, meh. And that means we start your very special day with a very special birthday breakfast. We made all of your favorites. Crispoong. So now Bad Kitty woke up. Aardvark bagels. I've never read that word before. I don't know what that is. But I do know what bagels are. Clam donuts. Elf fritters. Grilled hummingbirds. Grilled hummingbirds. Iguana jelly. Koala lemonade. Mongoose and nuts. Or June pancakes. I don't know, like, what that is, because I don't know what food that is. I know what pancakes are, though. Quetzal raisin bread. Snake tortillas. Unicorn and vegetable juice. Walrus and XO sauce. And for dessert, a yak zabanlia. I don't know what that says. But I think that's like a made-up word. That illustration is weird. I don't know what that is. That's all that stuff. But, kind of weird. But yeah. Put on. Gobble, gobble. Slobber munch, gobble slurp, chew chew, yum, slobber, gulp slurp, zoom. Yeah, because Betty just ate all of that stuff. Burp, snore. Oh, come on, kitty. You're not going to sleep all day again, are you? All you did yesterday was sleep. And all you did the day before yesterday was sleep. Are you going to do nothing but sleep every single day? Okay, Uncle Murray's fun facts. Because there's Uncle Murray's fun facts. Why do cats sleep so much? I don't know, maybe they're tired. That's what it says. But this is here. The typical house cat will sleep an average of 16 hours a day. That's more than twice what the average human being sleeps. One reason cats sleep so much is because they're crepuscular. I don't know what that says. Which means that they are most active at dawn and at dusk. When the sun is rising and when the sun is setting, those are the times cats are used to hunting for their food. Okay. And back here, just looking in a mouse hole. Cats are also very light sleepers, even when they might look like they're sound asleep. All of their senses are still very active. For instance, you can see their ears wiggle and turn while they're sleeping. Yeah, I've seen my cat Toby do that all the time when he's sleeping. This way, cats can remain aware of their surroundings, even while they sleep, and can wake up very quickly if they need to. And there's like a bug across the floor. Skitter. It's like running across the floor. Some big cats, like lions, will eat so much after a successful hunt that they will sleep for 2 straight days afterward. Often it is only the female lions that do the hunting while the male lions do most of the sleeping. And then Uncle Murray says, "Hey, I like that idea. Eugene, go get me a sandwich." It's like that's someone. At the deli while I take a nap. I thought it was like deli white. And I was like, okay, what the? That doesn't make any sense. Okay, kitty, I get it. You're just going to sleep all day again. I guess I'll just decorate the house all by myself. I guess I'll just blow up the balloons all by myself. I guess I'll just let all the guests in all by myself. Snore. So bad kitty is still going to fall asleep. I guess I'll just eat the cake and open the presents all by myself. Flung. So bad kitty just like springs up out of bed. Wow, cats really can wake up quickly. Chapter 2, Kitty's first year. Okay, so, this is chapter 2. It's already been 9 minutes. Before we do anything else, Kitty, it's time for our favorite birthday tradition. It's time to go to the old photo album and remember all of those wonderful days from long ago. Look, kitty, here's a picture of you back in the animal shelter where we found you. Aw, you were so cute. Wow, that kitty looks really cute. I'm not going to show you the pictures, I'm just going to waste time. So, You were the sweetest, kindest, nicest kid in the whole shelter, and you were helpful too. Oh, those are cute pictures. You used to help keep all of the cages clean.
Sorry. My dad came in.
Because he didn't know I was making video. You used to keep all the cages clean. You liked to read to all the other kittens. And you always shared your food. And then she's reading Puss in Boots. Look, kitty, here are pictures of your mother. You and Mama Kitty were very close. The day eventually came when it was time for you to leave the shelter. That's when you came home to live with us. But you didn't want to go. You didn't want to leave Mama Kitty, even though you were old enough. You just bit the guy. There's pictures of it. Okay. Uncle Murray's fun facts. Okay. Ah, heck, Jeannie. I was only kidding about the sandwich. I don't know who Jeannie is. Okay, cats mature much faster than human beings. The typical house cat reaches adulthood when it is only 12 to 18 months old. Human beings can barely walk at that age. So when a cat is only 12 weeks old, it is a probably old enough to leave its mother and go to a new home. 12 weeks might seem very young to you and me, but to a cat, it's perfectly normal. Okay, so it shows this. That's really cool. Okay, it is very important not to remove a kitten from its mother before it is 12 weeks old. Kittens learn a lot of important things from their mothers before they're adopted. They learn how to use their litter box properly. They learn how to eat solid food. If you remove a kitten from its mother too early, the kitten might have a more difficult time learning these important lessons from you. Kittens 12 weeks. Litter box. Got it. Look, I gotta run out and buy some flowers. Okay. Because that was Uncle Murray's in there. Okay. We loved you right away, even though you were sometimes pretty grumpy. Away from your mother, you weren't the same helpful little kitten that we first met. But we still love you. Okay. Lots of pictures. There's a dog. Although you don't always make it easy. That's great. Every party needs decorations.
Okay, so there's gonna be some decorations. Yeah.
Okay, kitty, let's get started. The first thing we do is pull out the box of decorations we use every year. Kitty's big box of birthday decorations. There's an illustration. Why don't you help me blow up some balloons? That's not helping, kitty. He just popped. I mean, she just popped one of the balloons. Okay, why don't you help me hang some streamers? Happy birthday, and there's some streamers. That's not helping, kitty. She just scratched them all up.
No, there's none.
Okay, kitty. Why don't you help me put this incredibly delicate, valuable glass birthday vase that's been in my family for a dozen generations onto the mantle. On second thought, maybe I'll just leave this in the box. All right, Kitty. Since you don't want to help me blow up balloons or hang streamers, will you at least help me to set up the table for all the presents you're going to get? That's right, Kitty. All you need to do is help me spread the special birthday party tablecloth onto the table. Thank you, Kitty. Now you're being helpful. So she just spread the birthday party tablecloth onto the table. Gosh, the table looks so festive. Except, I think it's missing one little thing, Kitty. What do you think that one little thing is, Kitty? It's missing presents, of course. So I'm going to put one there right now. It's a big surprise, Kitty. And I know it's something you really want, Kitty. And that you really, really... No, that you really, really want. That you really, really, really want. But you have to promise me that you won't open it until the party. Bad Kitty's gonna open it, I know it. Remember, Kitty, you promised not to open the present yet. You promised. She hasn't opened it, but she's like looking at it. She's imagining what's in there. She's imagining that there's a fish, some milk, some meat, some chicken, a zebra, or a puppy cage, because there's a puppy, and Bad Kitty doesn't like the puppy, and that's in the house. Where are you going, Kitty? The guests will be here any minute now. Dig, dig, Russell. She's looking in her bed. Okay, it looks like she pulled out the newspaper. The giant catalog of cat toys. And the cat says, I want everything. It's because there's a cat on the cover of the book that she's holding, that Kitty's holding. And it says, the giant cat in the log, so. Because cat. Be the most popular cat in your neighborhood with the world's greatest cat scratcher. Silk cushion stuffed with hummingbird feathers. Baobab wood base lined with diamonds. Bronze wire forged from the Statue of Liberty's toenail. The Statue of Liberty's toenail. Artificial mink fur balls dipped in beef gravy. Ropes made from the wool of mountain-dwelling llamas that only ate catnip for 20 years. Only $599.99. Wow, that's a lot of money. It's been 18 minutes. Uncle Murray's fun facts. Hey, Jeannie. I brought you some pretty daisies. All cats like, that's what Uncle Murray just said. All cats like to scratch things. They'll scratch soft things like chairs or sofas. Yeah, I know. They'll scratch hard things like table legs or dressers. They'll scratch fuzzy things like rugs or carpets. Cats will scratch just about anything. Sometimes they'll do it for fun or exercise, but they'll also scratch things because their claws are like our fingernails. They never stop growing. But unlike our fingernails, a cat's claws grows in layers, so cats will sometimes scratch something to rub off an old layer for a newer, fresher, sharper claw layer. And it shows the illustration. Old claw layer peeling off. Okay, that looks weird. The scratch marks they leave behind are also very important for a cat's they mark a cat's territory. Those scratches are territory markers for other cats to both see and smell. Inside a cat's paw, pads are little scent glands that leave little odors on anything they scratch. They act like messages for other cats to read. This table leg belongs to me. There's like a note saying that on it. Okay. I forgot that Genie is allergic to flowers. I don't know who Genie is. I forgot. I don't really know if Genie has been in any of the books. I don't know who Genie is. And it shows Bad Kitty holding her book. The dog looking at it. And then she puts it in her bed. And the dog looks at it. With like slobber coming down from its tongue. And then grabs it. So that's gonna be bad. Ding dong! The guests are here, Kitty! Let's meet them at the door! Chapter 4. Every party needs guests. Ding dong! It's Big Kitty! Big Kitty is the biggest kitty in the whole neighborhood. Big Kitty is much bigger than Kitty. Big Kitty weighs much more than Kitty. Everything about Big Kitty is bigger. Even his hairballs are pretty darn big. I sure hope we have enough birthday cake. Even Big Kitty's present is big. Wow, I wonder what it could be. Kitty, why don't you open your presents later when... Never mind. Rip. Tear. Okay, so she just opened the present and she's imagining that's going to be that cat scratch thing. Look, Kitty, it's a dead mouse. So the mouse is actually alive. I can't believe that. It was like, the present is actually like, the box is super big. But literally there was just a mouse in there. A dead mouse. Not even a dead mouse. It's an alive one. Ka-zing. I guess it wasn't dead after all. Ding dong. It's the twin kitties. The twin kitties are holding presents. Because they're like, well, not holding. The presents are on their heads. There are two of them. The twin kitties are brother and sister, and the cutest kitties in the whole neighborhood. More than anything, they love to play. And they love to play with Kitty. On those rare occasions when Kitty is not in the mood to play with them, they play with Pup. Look, Kitty. They brought you not one, but two presents. I wonder what's in them. And she's imagining that they're both two of those cat scratchers. Rip, rip, rippity, rip, rippity, rip. Look, Kitty. It's a ball of string. And a ball of twine. How thoughtful. That would have been cool for cats, but Bad Kitty doesn't like it. And now the twin kitties are playing with them. I'll just put them on the present table where they'll be safe. Ding dong! It's Stinky Kitty! Stinky Kitty is the cough. Stink is the cough because the person just coughed. Stinkiest kitty in the whole choke neighborhood. So they just choked. He never brushes his teeth. Then it shows stuff in his teeth. Onion, sardines, garlic, and liver. He's always getting dirty. So he's like going in like dirt or something. Yeah, he's going in like a bunch of dirt. That would suck to be going in. He likes to sleep in his litter box. Ew, that's gross. It's gonna make him even more stinky. But Stinky Kitty did bring you a very nice looking present. I wonder what it hatch is. Because the present's hatch. Okay. Rip Shred. And then she's imagining it's the cat scratches thing. Look, Kitty, it's an old cardboard paper towel tube. Oh well, Kitty. It's the start that counts. Let's put it on the present table where it will be safe. Ding dong. It's Chatty Kitty. And Chatty Kitty always is meowing. So it's like meow 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 meow. And it says there's like that mouse, that like mouse, and it's saying Chatty Kitty is really saying, a funny thing that happened to me on the way to the party. I saw a stick that was shaped just like a chicken bone, only it didn't smell like a chicken bone at all. Mostly smelled like a stick. I find that sticks almost never smell like chicken bones unless you were to rub the stick with a chicken bone. But why would you do that? Chatty Kitty is the why am I saying that? That was just Chatty Kitty talking. But Chatty Kitty is the... She likes to... And like... A bunch of... So, this is a bunch of meowing. And she even likes to... Meow, 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 meow. And she likes to... Meow, 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 meow. Never mind. And... I have to turn the book this way to read this part, because this is what Chatty Kitty is saying. But it doesn't always do this, just the illustration made it so that there's only room for it to be like this. Why do you suppose oranges are called oranges? Do you think it's because they are colored orange? Or is the color orange called orange because it's the color of oranges? I wonder why all fruits aren't named after their colors. Grapes could be called purples, and a bunch of grapes could be called a bunch of purples. Unless they're white grapes, which really aren't white at all, but more of a pale green. But you'd still have to be careful, because if you asked for a bunch of purples, someone might give you a big pile of eggplants, which would just be silly, because cats don't eat eggplants, or grapes, or oranges either. That's what Chatty Kitty was saying. Chatty Kitty has brought you such a nice looking present. Why don't you open it right now? Do you think I could borrow some of that paper to put in my ears? Meow 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 meow. That's Chatty Kitty, and this is what Chatty Kitty said. A moth got into the house the other day, only I wasn't sure if it was a moth or a butterfly, because it was big like a butterfly, but brown and gray like a moth. And I tried to catch it, but it flew too high for me. Which is good because some butterflies are poisonous if you eat them, which is gross. But sometimes I can't help myself. It didn't matter though because it turned out to be just a feather anyway. Look, Kitty, it's a collection of old moth bulbs she found in the closet. No, 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 no. So Chatty Kitty was just meowing, but she said, I don't know if it's a he or she, but Chatty Kitty said, they also ward off butterflies. Don't eat them. So that's just like a bunch of dead moths that, like, the Chatty Kitty, like, had and put into a ball. I guess kitties aren't the best gift givers. Oh well. Let's put them on the table where they'll be safe. Oh, so that was the gift. Ding dong. It's Pretty Kitty. And then the mouse is saying, those eyes. Because it's Pretty Kitty. It's so pretty, I guess. Pretty Kitty is the prettiest kitty in the whole neighborhood. And she knows it. She's won over a dozen cat shows. All the boy kitties are madly in love with her. Even the present that Pretty Kitty brought is pretty. It's almost too pretty, too. Rip. Rip. Gronk. Gronk. So, Bad Kitty is imagining that it's going to be the scratcher. So, look, Kitty, it's some tufts of Pretty Kitty's pretty fur. Oh, Kitty, don't be like that. It's just pretty fur. That fur has won prizes at cat shows. I'll put it on the present table where it will be safe. Ding dong. It's Strange Kitty. Hello. And it says that's what Strange Kitty just said. And then the mouse is saying, nice hat. Because it's like a top hat he's wearing. Strange Kitty is the oldest kitty in the whole neighborhood. Maybe even the whole world. In fact, some people aren't convinced he really is a kitty. Like all the other kitties, he has no fur. Not a single hair. And then, unlike all the other kitties, he wears a hat and a necktie. Unlike all the other kitties, he would rather sit and read comic books by himself than scratch things, or chase mice, or sleep all day. And he's, like, reading a comic book. And he's like, neat. Look, Kitty. I think Strange Kitty brought you a present, too. He brought you a comic book. Isn't that nice? Say thank you. That's not how we say thank you, Kitty. It's a very thoughtful gift. I'll put it on the present table where it will be safe. So the comic book is called Wonder Kitty. And why I said that's not how we say thank you, Kitty, is because Bad Kitty is sticking her tongue out at Strange Kitty. Hey, where are all the other presents I put there? Where is the comic book Strange Kitty just gave you? And Strange Kitty's reading a different comic book. He's reading Goat Justice League. Kitty, did you do something with all the presents? No? Well, if you didn't do something with all of your presents, then Chapter 5, Who Stole the Presents? Chatty Kitty is meowing, and Strange Kitty is reading mystery comics. So
that is gonna be the end of the video. If you like these books,
then please just tell me. But
I will see you guys all later. Because it's been 35 minutes of me reading this. So I will see you guys all later. But please tell me if you like this book. I will. This is just part one of it. I will be reading more of it. But I will see you all later. Please subscribe. Turn on those notifications. And please like this video if you like it, and if you don't like it, or you don't like this book, maybe dislike it. I don't know. We've never gotten any dislikes, but and why we don't have any is because no one views our videos, except for like the dumb Spider-Man videos are the only ones that are viewed. Oh, and that Truth or Dare video that we did. But I'll see you guys all later. This has been fun reading this. Please subscribe, and I will see you guys all later. Bye.